I have a coaching client who facilitated the very first sprint planning session 1 month ago. It was prior to her working with me. She told me that it went really well. The team was able to decide on a sprint goal, on what stories they need to accomplish to meet that sprint goal, estimate the stories, commit to accomplishing a certain amount of stories. And they started the sprint. 2 weeks later, at the end of the sprint, the team realized that they completed only half of what they said they would do. Only half of the stories, and they couldn't meet the sprint goal. Are you having the same issues with your teams? Well, if that's the case, this video is for you. We're gonna cover two tips that will guarantee that your next planning session is effective, together with a checklist to make sure, to ensure that you never encounter the same issues again related to sprint planning. Well, obviously you need to implement what I share in this video for this to happen. First off, sprint planning is one of the Scrum ceremonies or events widely utilized by teams who use sprints to actually mark when work starts and ends. It is designed mainly to answer two questions. First, what can we deliver as a team in the next sprint? What is the valuable product that we can put in the market at the end of the next sprint? What is the most important thing that will bring the most value to the customer that we can put to the market in the next sprint? And second, how can we do it? So basically, what can we do and how can we accomplish this task? If you don't know what Agile Scrum is, I did a full breakdown of exactly that in this video right here. You can watch that at the end of this video. Tip number one to run to facilitate an effective sprint planning session is to review your roadmap, your product roadmap. Scrum Master and Agile Coach Robin Sherman says, there's always too many features that would add value, therefore creating a lack of focus on the vision and goals. By focusing on the features too much, the roadmap will turn into an overload product backlog instead of a high-level strategic plan for the product's future development. The goal of Agile and Scrum is to release valuable products faster, but it's easier said than done. It's easy to lose sight of a big picture, the roadmap, when you're stuck in the day-to-day coding, writing requirements, doing the design, fixing bugs, overproduction issues. Prior to your next sprint planning session, yeah, I said prior, that's prep work, preparation work. So prior to your next sprint planning session, take a step back to reflect on your product roadmap. Look at it. Is it valid? If not valid, please update it. If it's valid, what are you trying to accomplish with that product roadmap? How do you know that you're focusing on the right things? Are you releasing stuff to please loud customers or bring you closer to your product vision? Where do you want to be in 3 months, 6 months, 1 year, or even more? Is the next sprint bringing you closer to that goal, to that product vision, or not? Tough questions, but questions that you need to ask yourself prior to each sprint planning to ensure that you're focusing on the right thing. Tip number two, groom your backlog and user stories. The sprint planning involves two key tasks. First, grooming the backlog, and second, deciding how much work to take in the next sprint. Grooming the backlog or the backlog refinement should be done prior to the actual planning, a few days prior or even 1 week prior, if you can do that. The goal is to ensure that you have a healthy backlog, a backlog which is prioritized with the most important work on top, a backlog that contains fully formed and written stories following the INVEST acronym. Using INVEST ensures that you have well-written stories that developers understand and developers can actually work on in the coming sprint. If you don't spend time prior writing the stories, writing well-crafted stories, you're wasting a lot of time in the actual sprint with redoing requirements, rewriting the stories. That's a total waste of time. Prep work prior to starting the sprint, really important. INVEST means independent, negotiable, valuable, estimable, small, and testable. Independent stories should be as far as possible independent of each other. You should be able to work on the story and especially release and complete the story without waiting for something else to complete, independent of each other. Negotiable crafting user stories isn't that something that the product owner sets in stone. No, the team works together to craft these user stories, and there's negotiations throughout the process.
Valuable user stories should add value to the customer. Estimable user stories should be not too big or not too small. Around 40 hours of work should be required to complete a user story.
Testable user stories should have acceptance criteria to test if they actually fulfill the customer's needs.
Now, really important, there's a reason why the backlog refinement or backlog grooming is done a few days prior to the actual sprint planning. Sometimes or often, the product owner, when showing the stories to the team, when crafting the stories together, might have some questions. The product owner might get some questions from the development team in terms of, is this really bringing value? Why don't we do it like that? Can this really be done? The development team might feel that this story is too complex, can't be done with the current technology that we have.
The developers might ask questions to the product owner that the product owner can't answer right now, needs to check with someone else and get back to the team.
This, all these things, back and forth, which is good, a good sign of ensuring that valuable stuff are going to be released, things that the customer actually wants. It's a good sign when the team is discussing and talking about stories. All these things take time, though. It might take a few days. And imagine now if you do that during the sprint planning, you're delaying your sprint planning by days. So it's better to do it prior.
Using these two tips alone will be a game changer for your next sprint planning session, because you will be well prepared. And talking about preparation, let's quickly go through a preparation checklist that I have for you.
First, backlog prep. We already talked about that a few minutes ago.
Second, measure user stories. Ensure that the user stories are not too big, not too small. Around 40 hours to complete a user story. The more the team works together, the better the team will be at breaking down these user stories and ensure that they are the right size.
Third, examine the team's commitment and establish the team's velocity. At this point, I usually take 3 sprints back. What's the average of points? Story points, stories that we completed. Ask the team during the sprint planning session. We'll talk about that in a few minutes. But you actually ask the team, is this average okay? Should we take more points in this sprint? Should we take less story points in this sprint? What do you think? The team decides, not you, not the product owner. The team decides together how much we can work on, how much work can be done in the sprint. And it's only an estimate, and we get better at this the more the team works together. It's really important that if a product owner starts forcing people, developers, to do a certain amount of point, you need to stop the product owner from doing that.
Really important to ensure here that you know if someone is going on leave, if someone is in training full day, this needs to be taken into account when actually doing the sprint planning. Because if 2 people are on leave for the next 2 weeks, obviously you'll do less in terms of story points compared to a previous sprint.
After that, it's time for the actual sprint planning session. Ensure that everyone who is not on leave is present in this meeting, in this session. It's really important that everyone, it's a group effort to actually do a sprint planning. First thing you need to do is remind the team of a big picture or goal. This is when you have a quick look at the roadmap and the goal of a sprint.
Second, discuss any new information that may impact the plan, any last minute updates from stakeholders, urgent requests or bug fixing required.
Third, agree on how much work the team thinks they can accomplish in the next sprint.
You're already prepared for that. You did some prep work. You know how many people are on leaves. You know the team's capacity, the training and all that. You know the average velocity.
The team, let the team decide how much work they will take in the next sprint.
Fourth, show the backlog items, the stories that we want to complete in the next sprint.
Really important to ask the team, if you are a Scrum Master or anyone in the team, ask the team, are we sure that completing these stories will make us meet the sprint goal, also complete the sprint goal? Really important that you focus on the sprint goal. And it's a good time also to examine or check your definition of done and your definition of ready.
Fifth, focus on the how. What do we need to do as a team to accomplish, to actually accomplish, to complete this story? Is it too big? Is it too small? Does a story take more than 40 hours? Do we need to split the stories? All the things that you couldn't do in the backlog grooming, you might have other questions that you, when you see the story another time in the actual planning. It shouldn't be a lot. It shouldn't be something that's a complete blocker that
blocks you from completing the sprint planning session, but obviously people have questions even if it's their 10th time looking at a story. Once the team agree that the story meets the definition of ready, it's time to estimate the story. And once you've estimated all the stories, actually take the story, decide on how much stories you'll take, the team will be able to work on in the next sprint that usually match the average velocity of a team if there's no leaves plan or trainings plan and all that. The team decides that, not the product owner. The team is not forced to do a number of stories. No, let the team decide that. And the team will get better at estimating how much they can accomplish the more they work together. And the last thing is starting the sprint. That's it. You have now a sprint backlog. These are things that you need to focus on. A sprint goal that you have to accomplish. The team decided and committed on a sprint, a number of stories on a sprint goal. They said they would accomplish that. So, as a Scrum Master, you need to ensure that they have everything, all the help required to accomplish that. So yeah, you started the sprint. Now it's time to celebrate that and maybe hug each other. If you want more tips, insights on Agile, Scrum, personal growth, click on the video that stands out the most on the screen right now, and I'll see you in a few seconds.